If you have an older air conditioner or refrigerator, the current gas used to keep your appliances cool will be discontinued. Now, this will force many of you to buy new appliances if something goes wrong. KPLC's Alma Cirbo explains the reason for the change.
Although the law goes into effect next year, one local appliance store has already started following suit.
All refrigerators have pretty much changed by now. So smaller refrigerators changed at the beginning of 2022. So everything we sell now uses the new gas, and we don't use any of the old hydrofluorocarbons at all.
According to EPA, stricter limits on the gas hydrofluorocarbon will help with global warming.
There's a lot less of it. It is much more energy efficient, so it gets just as cold. It is much more safer to inhale. We don't have to use a recovery machine like we did on the old units.
To every pro, there's a con. One being the new change could leave consumers with no choice but to purchase new ACs and refrigerators.
It'll be much, much more expensive to work on. So if a customer has a refrigerant or an air conditioner that uses the old refrigerant, sometimes it's not repairable anymore because the gas is just not available to us.
Wright gives us a rough estimate of pricing.
So if you were looking at a $600 refrigerator, you're probably $679 or somewhere in that ballpark now versus what it was 2 years ago. And part of that is directly related to them having to change to the new gas.
Once the mandate kicks in, Wright says there will be nothing appliance companies can do, a reminder as we go through the summer season.
After you get to a certain date, there's nothing you can do. It's against the law for them to build them anymore. They have to build the new equipment. And so the consumer is just stuck.
In Lake Charles, I'm Acerbo, 7 News.
And penalties for not following the new rule when it goes into effect includes possible license revocation, fines, and criminal penalties.